In today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up a Termux web server that uses PHP and has access to MySQL databases. In addition, we are going to install WordPress to check that everything works correctly. If you want all the commands used to copy and paste, I leave in the description of the video a link to a new GitHub that I have created with all the projects that I will be doing. The first thing we will do is to start Debian in Termux. I leave you a video in the description where I explain how to get to this point. We open a terminal and install Apache 2 to manage the web server. We are going to move to the folder where will be the files that will be offered in the web server. By default, the index.html file is created. Let's start the web server with the command you see. The first time it will give error because the port 80 will be busy and we will have to change it in the Apache 2 configuration. We open the Apache 2 configuration file with the command you see. Change the port where it says listen 80. And put any other number that is not in use, for example 8082. Save the changes and exit. We try to start again the Apache 2 server, and now everything should work correctly. We can check the status of the service with the commands you are seeing. Now we only have to go to the web browser to the address, localhost, with the port that we have specified in the configuration file previously. If you want to just show simple HTML, you can modify the index.html file with whatever you want. As you can see, if we change it, the changes will be shown in the web server. When we want to stop serving the web page, we can stop the Apache 2 server with the stop command. Next, we are going to install PHP to be able to use this language in our web server. We use the command you see on the screen. To check if we can use PHP in our web server, we are going to go to the web server path and we are going to modify the index to use PHP code. In this example, we are going to print a simple text. Let's go back to the localhost page with the port we have configured, but don't forget to have the Apache server running or else it will show us an error that it is not able to reach the web. We can check how the PHP code is being interpreted. Anyway, let's do another test showing the PHP version that our web server is using. We restart the web server and check that now a PHP general information page is shown where we can see the general information and the PHP version used. Now we are going to proceed to install and configure MariaDB as SQL server for the WordPress website we are going to set up. We restart the Apache server, and we are going to delete the index file that we have created before. We proceed to download the latest version of WordPress available. In this case, it gives an error because we do not have the WGT package installed, so we install it and run again the same command to download WordPress. Unzip the file just downloaded. We move all the contents of the WordPress folder to the current path. Finally, we delete the downloaded file in the empty WordPress folder. With this, we already have all the files in their corresponding place. Now we are going to give the appropriate permissions for the web server with the command you see on the screen. With everything ready, we have to start the MySQL service with the following command. While this command is running, we are going to start the MySQL installation process. We configure MySQL as we need it. In this case, I will follow the recommended configuration for WordPress. When we finish configuring MySQL, we can access the database server as you see on the screen and using the root user password. You can see the databases we have in the system. Now we are going to create a database called WordPress with all the necessary configuration for our website. I remind you that I have left below in the comment box a link to my GitHub where you can copy and paste all these commands. At this point, I have restarted Termux to make sure that all services were stopped, so we proceed to start them one by one. The first thing is to start the Apache 2 server as we have seen before. If we now go to our browser with the port we have configured, we can see the default WordPress page with which we can start the installation. Select the language and click Next. Here we have to write the name of the database that we have created before. In this case, we have called it WordPress. We also have to specify the root user and the root password so that WordPress can access the database. We will get the following error that it has not been able to connect to the database. This is because we have not yet started the MySQL service, so let's go with it. We open a terminal and execute the command you see on the screen. We will leave this terminal open with the process running and return to the WordPress page to continue with the installation. Now we fill in the data of our website, such as the name it will have and the username and password we will use to manage it. Once we press the button, we can go to the login page and from there manage all WordPress. You can check the default page that has been created, and it is now accessible from any device in our home network, not only from Termux. Finally, I show you how you can terminate the MySQL process if you ever get stuck in the background. We will use the PS command to find the process number and end it with the kill command. I hope you liked the video, even if it is a bit long. If you want more projects like this one, propose me new ideas in the comments, subscribe and share the video.